Hello, welcome to round two. This is the second of two recitals. There are different students in each recital, and the seniors and the associate teachers will perform in both, so you're in for a real treat. I would like to encourage everyone to remain until the end to support all of the students. Your child will be a senior or an older student one day as well, and they've all worked so hard, and they deserve the same attentive audience. We actually split this long recital into two parts so that that would happen, so that everyone would have supportive audience, okay? Anyway, some brief but very important recognitions at the end for the seniors and the associate teachers, and a few important announcements as usual. If you exit in an emergency, please do so in between the students' performances, not during. And don't walk across here, if you would, please, and just go around the outside because of the videography that's going on and the photography. And if you have a little one that gets really loud, if you would take them out, because the students really need to focus and concentrate, and sometimes that can really affect their concentration. So you probably have already done this, but take your cell phones if you have not, and turn those off or put them on silent. All right. And then we are here for a celebration of all ages and levels, from preschool through college and adult students. You will enjoy a variety of musical styles, and the songs that are chosen represent some of those favorite musical styles of each student. We want you to be our participating audience. That means big smiles for the students, hearty applause, really let them know that you are their biggest fan and cheerleader, okay? I will not be announcing each student because that would take a lot of extra time. I think they all know who they're supposed to follow in the order. So I'd like to ask if you would save your applause to their final bow. They will bow twice, once at the beginning of their performance and once at the end. And if you would, just wait for that final bow. And then for the vocalists, please leave the mic on. Don't turn it off, because if you turn it off, the next student, we won't be able to hear them unless we start them again. So anyway, the mics will just stay on. It's in the up position, and there is a white line that looks like a straight white line if the mic is on. So we're going to go ahead and get started. The first precious little student had to go out of town with his family. It's actually Debbie Adams with Event Messenger. It's her grandson, and she brings him to lessons so faithfully. But anyway, Ethan Daly is not here, so I don't think I've told Trey this, but we're going to go ahead and start with Trey Satterwhite, and after that, we'll just roll right along.
You might have a mom, she might be the bum, but ain't nobody got a mom like mine. Her love never ends, she's my best friend. Ain't nobody got a mom like mine. She's my world, she's my heart, there ain't no denying. I'm a girl, no matter what, even when I'm on No. You All but gone. How could I? to hold my breath, let it stay this way. Thank you.
come to knock down your door. I can't hide this time like I hid before. The storm is awake, the danger is real. My time's run out. Don't feel. And fear will be your enemy, and death its consequence. That's what they once said to me, and it's starting to make sense. All this pain, all this fear began because of me. Is this thing they see the thing I have to be? A monster, were they right? Has the dark in me finally come to light? Am I a monster? Full of rage, nowhere to go but on a rampage. Or am I just a monster in a cage?
In this winter, bring back summer. Your daughter, no harm comes to her.
What do I do? No time for crying now. I started a storm, gotta stop it somehow. Do I keep on running? How far do I have to go? And would that take the storm away or only make it grow? I'm making my world colder. How long can it survive? Is everyone in danger as long as I'm alive? Was I a monster from the start? How did I end up with this frozen heart? Bringing destruction to the stage. Caught in a war that I never knew to wage. Do I kill the monster? Father, you know what's best for me. If I die, will they be free? Mother, what if after I'm gone, the cold gets colder, the storm rages on? No, I have to stay alive to fix what I've done, save the world from myself, and bring back the sun. I'm a monster, and it's true. There's only one thing that's left for me to do. But before I fade to white, I'll do all that I can to make things right. I cannot be a monster. I will not be a monster. Not tonight.
explain for you how one could start again, how hardened hearts could soften like a child. Don't ask me how to reason out the mysteries of life, or how to face its problems with a smile. Listen, go ask the man who's found a way through tangled roads back home to stay, when all communications were destroyed. Go ask the child who's walking now, once was crippled, then somehow her useless legs were made to jump for joy. Go ask the one whose burned out mind has been restored. I think you'll find the questions not important as before. Don't ask me if he's good or bad. I only know the guilt I had is gone, and I can't tell you anymore. Don't ask me how to prove to you why I know God is there, and how I know that he could care for you. Don't ask me why someone so great would choose to walk with me, or trade my broken life for one that's new. Listen, go ask the child who's got a dad to love away the hurt he had before this man called Jesus touched their lives. Go ask the man whose drums are fled, whose churning heart was quieted when someone whispered peace to all her strife. Go ask the one to tell you more, whose life was just a raging war inside himself until the Savior came. I don't pretend to be so wise. I only know touch my eyes and nothing else will ever be the same. Oh, I don't pretend to be so wise. I only know he touched my eyes and nothing else will ever be the same.
Before I start, the song I'm doing is Zombie, originally done by the Cranberries. I'm doing the Bad Wolves version, which is more of a rock version. And it was written in response to a couple of children that were killed in an IRA bombing. And with all the violence going on today, I think it really still hits home. And it also really hits home as a coworker of mine, Chris, was killed at McAfee Knob. You know, and it's just this helpless violence that we don't need. And I really think the song still pertains to today. So I would like to dedicate it to Chris's memory.
Silence, who are we mistaken? But you see, it's not me, it's not. In your head, in your head, yeah.
Well, the road rolls out like a welcome mat to a better place than the one we're at. And I ain't got no kind of plan. I had all this town I can stand. Well, I got friends out on the coast. We can jump in the water and see what flows. We've been saving for a rainy day. Let's beat the storm and be on our way. It don't matter to me wherever we are, it's where I wanna be. And only for once in our life, let's take our chances and roll the dice. I can be your lucky penny, you can be my four-leaf clover, starting over. Time. There's rivers to cross and hills to climb. Some days we might fall apart, and some nights might feel cold and dark. Nobody wins afraid of losing, and the hard roads are the ones worth choosing. Someday we'll look back and smile and know it was worth every mile. It don't matter to me wherever we are, it's where I wanna be. And honey, for once in our life, let's take our chances and roll the dice. I can be your lucky penny, you can be my four-leaf clover, starting over.
lady sitting on her old front porch, watching the chickens peck the ground. There ain't a whole lot going on tonight in this one horse town. Over yonder, coming up the road in a beat up Chevy truck, her boyfriend Tommy, he's laying on the horn, splashing through the mud and the muck. Her daddy says he ain't worth a lick. When it comes to brains, he got the short end of the stick. But Katie's young and man, she just don't care. She'd follow Tommy anywhere. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. And even if they had to run away, Tommy at the drive-in movie, parked in the very last row. They're too busy holding on to one another to even care about the show. Later on outside the tasty breeze, Tommy slips something on her hand. He says my high school ring will have to do till I can buy a wedding. When it comes to brains, he got the short end of the stick. But Katie's young and man, she just don't care. She'd follow Tommy anywhere. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. Till half past 12, when they come sneaking up the walk, he says, young lady, get on up to your room while me and Junior have a talk. Mama breaks in, says, don't lose your temper, it wasn't very long ago that you yourself was just a hayseed plowboy who didn't have a road to hoe. Daddy said you wasn't worth a lick. When it came to brains, you had the short end of the stick. But he was wrong, and honey, you are too. Katie looks at Tommy like I still look at you. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. What's meant to be will always find a way. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy.
again. It's just a matter of time. Go on, go on, till you reach the end of the line. 'Cause I know you'll pass my way again. It's just a matter of time. After I gave you everything I had, you laughed and you called me a clown. But remember, in your search for fortune and fame, what goes up must come down. I know that one day you'll wake up and find that my love is a true love. It's just a matter of time. Someday, some way, girl, you'll realize that you've been blind. Yes, darling, I know you're gonna need me again. It's just a matter of time. After I gave you everything I had, you laughed and you called me a clown. But remember, in your search for fortune and fame, what goes up must come down. I know that one day you'll wake up and find that my love is a true love. It's just a matter of time.
there, out in the darkness, a fugitive running, fallen from God, fallen from grace. God be my witness, I never shall yield till we come face to face, till we come face to face. He knows his way in the dark. Mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, the flames, the sword. Stars, in your multitudes, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. In the sky, you hold your course and your aim, and each in your season returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall in flames. For so it must be, for so it is written on the doorway to paradise, that those who falter and those who fall must pay the price. Lord, let me find him, that I may see him safe behind bars. I will never rest till then. This I swear, this I swear by the stars.
like a switch was flipped. I was just a kid, grew up strong enough to pick this armor up. Suddenly it fit. God, that was so long ago, long ago, long ago. I was little, I was weak and perfectly naive. I grew up too quick. Now you I wanna break these bones till they're better. I wanna break them right and feel alive. You were wrong, you were wrong, you were wrong. My healing needed more than time. When I see fragile things, helpless things, broken things, I see the familiar. I was little, I was weak, I was perfect too. Now I'm a broken mirror. But I can let you see all that I have to lose, all I've lost in the fight to protect it. I can't let you win. I swore never again. I can't afford. Just a kid, grew up scared enough to hold the door shut, bury my innocence. But here's a map, here's a shovel, here's my Achilles heel. Marlin palms out a match of mercy now, and I'm ready to begin. I am strong, I am strong. I am strong enough to let you
was June. I was 10. I still think of that day now and then.
Only eight, but so proud and serene. How they cheered, how I stared in that crowd of thousands. Then I started to run and to call out your name as the crowd on the road went wild. I reached out my hand and looked up. And then she smiled. The parade traveled on. With the sun in my eyes, she was gone. But if I were still 10 in that crowd of thousands, I'd find her.
Maybe you were. Make part of your story.
A parade.
Passing by.
It was hot, not a cloud in the sky. When a boy caught my eye. In a crowd of thousands. He was thin, not too clean. There were guards, but he dodged in between. Yes, he made himself seen in that crowd of thousands. Then he called out my name as he started to run through the sun and the heat and crowd. And I tried not to smile, but I smiled. And then he bowed.
I didn't tell you that.
You didn't have to. I remembered.
The parade
traveled on. With the sun in my eyes, you were gone. But I knew.
Sleeping in the woods, taking what I needed, working when I could, keeping up my courage, foolish as it seems, at night all alone in my dreams. In my dreams, shadows fall, there's a light at the end of a hall.
I'm sure at this point you feel like you're at a professional concert, but there's one more surprise for you. Simon Seeley sang a duet earlier in the first recital with Abby, but I didn't know he was going to be available to do a solo. So Simon is one of my former students who currently studies music and chemistry at ODU, and with this song, which is You'll Be Back from Hamilton, he actually won second place in the state as a vocalist. It was his senior year last year, 2022, in the Bland Foundation Music Scholarship Competition. So this is the last piece. It's a surprise, and Simon's going to come up now. I need to get my music ready.
And while she's doing that, first off, can we have a round of applause? She's been here since 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Please. 1:30, I lied. That's just when it started. So, 6 hours. Okay, before I begin, there's a little bit of context that's necessary for this song. It's from the musical Hamilton, which is a retelling of the Revolutionary War and a little bit after. So this song specifically is King George, like, yelling at the colonies because he's mad that they left. So it's kind of like a love song, or a breaking up song at an entire country. And I will be putting on a very bad British accent. Towards the end, there is a sing-along section. Trust me, by then you'll know what to do, but please feel free to actually sing.
You say the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea, when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back soon, you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say your love is draining and you can't go home. You'll be the ones complaining when I am gone. And now don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject, my sweet submissive subject, my loyal royal subject. Forever and ever and ever and ever and ever, you'll be back like before. I will fight the fight and win the war. For your love, for your praise, and I'll love you to my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we had. 'Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da.
Okay, let me go ahead and ask the seniors, Trey Saunders and Latriva Pierce, to come forward. We did this at the first recital, but I wanted to make sure that both recitals can experience the senior recognition and the associate teacher recognition. So let me start with Trey. Trey is a 2023 graduate of Lord Botetourt High School. He has been a dedicated voice student for the past few years, and he has quite a list of accomplishments and exciting future plans for continuing his music, and he'll share that in just a moment. He is a wrestler, a four-year varsity starter. He made it to states his senior year, which is this year. He is a member of the National FFA organization. It's the Future Farmers of America. You have some cute little baby goats, don't you? I've seen his little baby goats on Facebook. He is a National Honor Society member, an honor roll student, and you saw he's a great guitar player, singer, and songwriter. He has performed locally at the Hangout, Botetourt Farmers Market, Lackey's Art Studio, and Galax Fiddlers Convention. He was the second place vocal winner of the Local Bland Foundation Music Scholarship Competition, and the recipient of the Creative Arts Scholarship for, and let me let him tell you what it's for.
All right, so I'm going to East Tennessee State University, and I'm going to major in bluegrass, country, and roots music studies. I'm looking to go for an audio production.
Give him a round of applause.
Thank you.
Yeah, so you're going to keep studying guitar and voice, right? I can't remember exactly what you said. I didn't want you to leave anything out. Maybe some more mandolin and fiddle. I think I heard that from your mom. And so, yeah, he's pursuing a career in classic country music performance and production. Wow. I also made a note of this. East Tennessee State University's Bluegrass, Old Time, and Roots Music Program is the oldest established program of its kind at any four-year institution. I didn't even know it existed until you told me about it. That was amazing. Anyway, the ETSU bands have performed in numerous countries around the world, so you have a lot to look forward to. I have something to present to you, and I want you to keep in touch, and I want a hug.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Okay, Latriva Pierce. Latriva is a 2023 graduate of William Byrd High School and valedictorian. She has studied music with me for 7 years. She recently became one of my studio's associate teachers of piano and voice. And she's going to share her future plans in a moment, but I need to brag on her first. She is a high achiever both musically and scholastically. She also won the Levi Freeman Character Award. Some of her musical achievements include: she won first place the instrumental with the piano at the Bland Foundation Music Scholarship Competition twice. Now, you can only win it once at the state level, but she won it at the local level twice. A member of all district bands, Virginia Tech Honor Band. She received the John Philip Sousa Award. She is a member of the Symphonic, Jazz, and Marching Band for all 4 years of high school. And this is an honor. She was the drum major, the student conductor for 12th grade for the marching band, and also a woodwind captain. Some of her academic achievements. Now follow me on this. A honor roll throughout all of high school. Clap. Yes. A Beta Club member, she received CORD for 10 hours of volunteering. A Quest Bridge scholar, she's gonna explain what that is. She can do that better than I can. And an AP scholar. On the forensics team, she competed in dramatic interpretation. She was the regionals champion in 10th grade, the state runner-up in 10th and 12th grade, state's competitor in the 9th and 11th grade, and she placed second at state's in 11th grade. So let me let her share with you now her plans.
Hello. This fall, I'm going to be studying at Oberlin College. I will be double majoring in musical studies and creative writing. I got in through the QuestBridge program, which is a scholarship program that partners with top colleges in the U.S. I was a finalist for the Match Scholarship, which is like their big full ride. I unfortunately didn't get that, but I did get in through QuestBridge's regular decision and received almost a full ride.
Yes, and it's my understanding that the applicants for Oberlin College and Conservatory, they only accept about 10% of the applicants, right? And for that QuestBridge scholar, only about 1% receive that. So that's absolutely amazing. So anyway, I'm gonna forget to give you what I'm going to give you here. So I have something for you and a hug. I'm gonna see her during the summer though. And I would like her to remain here because now I'm going to recognize my associate teachers. So let me ask Abby Shelton to join us. And while she's coming up to the front, just a little bit about, and this won't take long, but a little bit about how all this came about. The addition of two associate teachers has allowed more students to begin their music education rather than just sitting on my waiting list. And the planning and the vision for this came very slowly, but what better choice for my two associate teachers than two current older students who are continuing and have continued their lessons in music education with me and whom I have continued to mentor through this process. In February, Latriva started her new young students, and in March, Abby began teaching hers. Abby teaches voice and is in the Salem area and Latriva has been teaching piano and voice here in the Vinton area. Even after only a few months of lessons, most of their students were able and chose to do the recital. I'm so proud of not only these young ladies, but their students as well. Now, as you have just seen that Latriva is going away to Oberlin College in Ohio, her students will need a teacher after summer is over. And initially, we were thinking she may end up at Virginia Tech and be able to come home a couple of days a week to continue teaching her students, and she may be able to do some virtual lessons with a few of the students while in college. But as much as we love her and we'll miss her, a blessing has fallen into place with another associate teacher who is a new adult voice student of mine who you heard perform today. Let me ask Angela Janney if she would come forward, please. So Angela is currently, she has currently been teaching students already, and she will be able to take both piano and voice students in this area. And she has had college music classes and 8 semesters of college piano in her younger years, and she is excited to join us. And I'm not gonna put her on the spot to share now. She told me earlier she was glad I didn't do that because I didn't let her know. But to quote her as we've been talking and texting back and forth, and I feel exactly the same way, but this is a quote from her. I feel like the Lord has been using so many things in my life over these past few years to prepare me for this very thing. And he definitely orchestrated me ending up at your studio for voice lessons. My true heart's desire is simply to share my own God-given love and passion for music with other people, which is what led me to start teaching in the first place. And I feel exactly the same way. So now back to Abby. I need to brag on all 3 of my ladies here. For those of you who do not know about some highlights of her impressive resume, Abby will continue to teach voice, and she is in the Salem area, and some of her highlights. In addition to several years of private voice lessons with me, Abby is a former teaching artist at PB&J Theater Company, a former teaching assistant at Roanoke Children's Theater. She won first place local and second place regional for the Bland Foundation Music Scholarship Competition in the vocal category in her senior year. She's had extensive roles in both musical theater and film, including Mill Mountain Theater, Showtimers Theater, Roanoke Children's Theater, and RCT Professional Youth Ensemble. She's had training in both acting and dance as well as musical theater and study with Stella Adler Studio of Acting. I'll end with saying that as the students of the associate teachers become intermediate to advanced students, they may transition to me as openings become available, but please help us get the word out about new young students desiring to take advantage of beginning their musical journey of either piano or voice lessons with one of these young, extremely capable ladies. Would you give them a hand? And just a few thank yous and we're out of here. First of all, let me thank you, the parents and the grandparents, for your support all year long. We are a team. We're doing this together. Please help me thank Greg Tuning, our sound technician today. He worked very hard. He always does a great job for us. And Jamie Archul of Enoch Creek Productions for videography for many years now. And Debbie Adams of the Vinton Messenger, the news writer and photographer. She covers all of our events, and she's so faithful to us. So give her a hand. And lastly, Kelly Ronan has given us technology assistance in preparing the track and the playlists. We couldn't have done the track playlist without her. So would you give Kelly a hand? Okay, well, I know this ran a little bit longer. Oh, my son's here. Hi, Timmy. Hi, Timmy. He's been doing things today with the taking pictures of the Iron Man going on. Usually he's in those races, but this time he, I don't even know how long you've been here, but anyway, that's my 34-year-old baby. And then I have, well, I've got to tell you this. I've already told you, I think you all know, but some of your guests, my 26-year-old son is expecting, he and his wife are expecting their first little boy, my grandson, in July. So I'm so excited about that. Now you got to clap. Yep. All righty. Thank you for your patience. This went a little bit longer than I expected. I hope I haven't forgotten anything, but thank you so much for coming.